It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, the Chief Investment Strategist and Managing Director here at Payne Capital Management. Wall Street threw a birthday party for the stock market this week, celebrating the longest bull market in history. Based on the low set back in March of 2000 for the S&P 500 index, this bull is 3,453 days old, or a little over 9 years, and higher by a whopping 320%. Now, the previous record, according to the Wall Street Journal, was set between October 1990 and March of 2000, except a lot of people invited to the party, like us, didn't show up. Since in our mind, the new high in the market this week, which was a new all-time record high in the S&P, was just another Wednesday in August. Like many, we think in terms of secular bull markets, and historically, secular bull and bear markets run about 14 years. And in these terms, the longest bull market in history, in my mind, started in 1982 and ended in the tech bubble of 2000. That's a period of 18 years. See, the point is, different people have different definitions for what is a bull market, and it's just not that important in the grand scheme of things. Here's what I know. Higher is better than lower. More is better than less, gaining is better than losing, and bull markets are much more fun than bear markets. See, it doesn't matter what the birth certificate says on this current market or what the born on dating date, you know, for you Budweiser fans, is on the current bull. This market is booming and has been booming since its bottom in 2009. Now, bull markets simply don't die of old age. They don't reach a certain length and then just keel over. What really matters is the underlying valuation. And believe it or not, the S&P 500 stocks are cheaper today, even though the price is at an all-time record high, than it was at the beginning of 2018. And that's because earnings have grown at a 20% annual rate. Moreover, value stocks, you know, companies like Exxon and JP Morgan, are trading at much lower valuation than growth stocks like Google and Amazon. And international and emerging market stocks are trading at valuations much lower than U.S.-based companies. So in spite of certain indices making new all-time record highs this week, there's plenty of opportunities to deploy your hard-earned capital. It serves you well to remember that all dips in all markets are temporary and new highs inevitable. And simply put, a well-diversified portfolio presents opportunities to buy low on a daily basis.